What is up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Andrew, if you don't know me, and I make BookTube videos, which are pretty fun, pretty lit. You should subscribe because, like, why not? But anyway, today I'm going to be doing a book haul, a giant book haul. I recently got so many books that I don't even, like, have room on my shelves for them, but I did get them from the Barnes & Noble's book sale, which they had, like, a half off sale, which was really good and, like, a great time to pick up books, so I just had to. To start things off on a good note, I got Carry On by Rainbow Rowell. If you know what this book is about, it is a parody, kind of Harry Potter, and there is a similar magic system. There's a magical school, and the main person is Simon Snow, who is basically supposed to be the person who is going to defeat the humdrum and save all the magical people from losing their powers. And he also has a roommate named Baz, who is his mortal enemy, but like enemies to lovers, I don't know, you gotta read it to find out. Sorry, my dog is just like chilling here, like, okay, he's just gonna stay, he's not gonna leave. So the next book I got is Stalking Jack the Ripper by Carrie Maniscalco. I don't know how to say that. Stalking Jack the Ripper is like basically a retelling of the whole Jack the Ripper thing, but it has like a twist and it's actually just like a new story, a play on to the story. I don't know, I haven't read it, so I don't really know, but I'm really excited about it, and I got this one from the bookstore, so you know I had to buy the sequel on the Barnes & Noble book sale because I already had one in paperback, so I was like, why not? So when I finish Stalking Jack the Ripper, I can just move straight on to Hunting Prince Dracula by Carrie Maniscalco because, you know, I'll have both of them, so I don't even have the last one. I don't have the last two, but I have those two. So the next book I picked up from the book sale is Legendary by Stephanie Garber. It is the sequel to Caravelle in the Caravelle series, and I have the first one, so I figured I would need the sequel, so I figured why not just get it half off from the Barnes & Noble sale, so I did. The next book I picked up was actually from the bookstore. It is Pride and Prejudice by Jane Austen. I love these Barnes & Noble classic editions. I have like a whole collection of them. So when I saw Pride and Prejudice, I literally just had to get it because I didn't have this one for my collection. The next book I picked up was Crown of Feathers by Nikki Powell Preto. This book is about two sisters who are both trying to be queen. The one we follow, I think, is the good sister, and she never wanted to hurt her sister, but now she might have to become queen to keep her sister from ruling the kingdom and leading them into disarray and bad times. So that's Crown of Feathers. I'm actually really excited about that one. The next book I picked up is Sorcerer of Thorns by Margaret Rogerson. This book is a fantasy that I have heard a lot about. It's been very hyped, so I'm excited to see what all the hype is about. Next one I got is They Both Die at the End by Adam Silvera. This book is about a world where you basically know when you're gonna die 24 hours in advance, and you can do whatever you want on that day. Because it's your last day, and you can meet up with people who are also dying that day and become friends, which is what our two main characters, Mateo and Rufus, do. And it is just their journey of their last day and their last hours together. Next I picked up This Is Where It Ends by Marieke Nijkamp. This book is told in 56 minutes rather than books usually being a lot longer than that, and it is about an active shooter in a high school in that kind of hostage situation. And I'm very sorry, I just got a phone call and I don't know what the last thing I said was, but I'm really intrigued by this book, and I hope that it is very good and deals with the topic of gun violence on a respectful and very like insightful way. The next book I got was The Wicked Deep by Shay Earnshaw. I don't know exactly a lot about this book. I know it has to do with like witchcraft, and I think maybe like the Salem witch trials. I've heard a lot about it, so that's what made me want to pick it up. The next book I picked up was The Upside of Unrequited by Becky Avertali. So The Upside of Unrequited is a it's pretty much just a love story, and I'm laughing because I keep reading the synopsis and it just makes me laugh, and it's just about this girl named Molly who has always had a bunch of crushes but never had a boyfriend or a girlfriend, and she doesn't understand how people get boyfriends and girlfriends, and that's just funny to me, and I'm excited to see if Molly can find love or not. I don't know. The next book that I have is With the Fire on High by Elizabeth Acevedo. This book is about a girl named Imani Santiago who was a teenager who got pregnant and had a child, and she is also a like basically food connoisseur, and she wants to become a cook like a really professional chef. It's just a book dealing with her struggles on being a mom and pursuing passions. And I know there are some elements in here that I'm probably missing, but I'm really excited because I've heard such good things about With the Fire on High. This cover is gorgeous, and I'm just very, very excited to read anything by Elizabeth Acevedo. So the next book that I have is I'm Not Dying With You Tonight by Kimberly Jones and Gilly Siegel. This book is a book about two girls who were never friends. They're pretty much opposites, and something goes down at a football game where there is a fire, I think, and just chaos breaks out, and they are somehow forced to be together as friends and figure out how to work together to survive the night. And this book also came with this bookmark, which is just really cute, and I love that. When I opened the book, it just fell out, and I was like, a surprise, like, that's really cute. So I really love this. This cover is actually very gorgeous too, and I even looked inside at the actual book, and I love that it has like an actual cover, whereas most books don't. And I think that's just very beautiful that you could take off the dust jacket and it still has, like, you know, a nice cover. The next book I got is Girls of Paper and Fire by Natasha Nan, I don't know how to say it, I'm sorry. And I got the Barnes & Noble exclusive edition, which I did get for a lot of these because they're the same price as the regular ones, and they were half off, so you might as well get that exclusive edition, you know? So I did, and I am very, very interested in Girls of Paper and Fire. I originally didn't have it in my cart, but then I went back and placed a second order because I was like, you know what, I think I need that book. I've heard a lot about it, so I really need to read it. So without me going into a kind of sorry explanation of what this book is about, because I have a very loose concept of it, let me just read the synopsis to you, and maybe that'll explain to you why I got hooked, okay? So, in my land, we're known as paper girls, easily torn, existing only for others to use and discard. But there's something they've all forgotten about paper. It can light the world on fire and make it burn. If that doesn't tell you something about a strong female character, then I don't know what will, but I'm very excited because I love me some strong female leads, some badass women, like, ruling the world, let me tell you. I love that. So I hope that's what I'm gonna get from Girls of Paper and Fire. The next book I got is The Kingdom by Jess Rothenberg. This book was kind of hyped for a little while, but then it died down because I don't think it got the best reviews. And my friend actually read this before me, and then she turned it in back to our bookstore, and then I bought it. But I don't know if I'm going to like it. It is a fantasy kind of set in a Disney setting, like Disney World, but there's a twist and like robotic things or something like that. I don't know. I'm interested. Probably won't get to it anytime soon, but if this is good, let me know, because I would really like to know other people's thoughts on whether or not it's good and move it up in my TBR list, so let me know. The next book I picked up was A Court of Wings and Ruin by Sarah J Maas. I do have a little, not a little, I have the whole Throne of Glass book set by Sarah J Maas, but nothing else, and I think this is in the, like, ACOTAR thing. Actually, I know it is, but I don't have ACOTAR, but this one came to the bookstore, so I could get it at a discounted price, so I was like, why not? I've heard very bad things about ACOTAR. Some people really hate it, but if you like it, please let me know, because I'm trying to get something that'll, like, make me want to read it and not feel like I wasted my money, but I'm kind of scared I did already anyway. But please, if you've read it, let me know what you thought, good or bad. I just want to know. So finally, the last book I have to show you guys is King of Scars by Leigh Bardugo. I am so happy. I now have every book by Leigh Bardugo, and I didn't even know I was, like, a big fan, but I am. After finishing Six of Crows, I am just, like, seriously so obsessed, and this book is beautiful. I got the Barnes & Noble exclusive edition again, and this book, I know, is centered around Nikolai and, like, Jenya and Zoya and everybody. I'm so excited to read the continuation of the Grishaverse right after the Civil War and Ravka and everything with Elena. All my books just fell. Like, that's great. That's just great. It is so hot in here. Oh my goodness. That was so many books. Okay. So finally, I am done. That was so many books. I usually don't have that big of a haul, but hopefully that'll last me for a while. I really don't need to buy any more books this year. If you see me buying books, literally yell at me and tell me to stop, but also mind your business because it's my money. Well, I hope you enjoyed. I hope you found some good books. I recommend all of these to you because if I even pick them up, then I think there is an inkling of it being good. Like, I usually don't pick up books unless I know or think that they're going to be good. So definitely, if you are stuck on, like, maybe you haven't been reading or you need something new to read, try any of these. I know I mostly read fantasy, but, like, that's just what I like to read. But I do hope that you could find something that you would enjoy from my, big haul. I do want to remind you before I go that I have a giveaway coming at 200 subscribers. So go ahead and share my channel if you would like to help me get to my goal of 200 subscribers by the end of the year. But yeah, I think that's all I have to say. Tell me down below if there's any books that I should get that I didn't in this haul that you have that maybe were super good. Like, tell me your 5 stars down below. Like, please. I'm always looking for good books to read. But that's pretty much all I have to say to you guys today. I hope you like this video. Hope you like this video down below, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!